previous video, I am explained up to the general purpose registers. Okay. Now I am continuing with the segment registers. Okay. Coming to the segment special purpose registers. In special purpose, there are three categories. One is segment register. Second one is pointer register. Next one is the index registers. These are 16-bit registers. Okay. Coming to the segment registers. Okay. It has four segment register. One is core segment. CS means core segment. Core segment, data segment, stack segment. SS means ES means extra segment. These segment registers are used to store the starting address of the segment. Okay? These segment registers are used to store the starting address of the segment. Segment is nothing but, suppose here the entire, what is the maximum storage capacity of the 8086/20, that is nothing but the 1 MB. This 1 MB is divided into the 16 logical segments. Okay? In these 16 logical segments, we are using only 4 segments. Those segments are core segment, data segment and stack segment and extra segment. Each and every this segment starting address is stored in the segment register. What is the purpose of the segment register? Starting address of that segment is stored in segment register. The detailed explanation I am concluding in the memory segmentation of the 8086. You can understand very easily. Next, coming to the pointer registers. Okay, coming to the pointer registers. Here, three pointer register: base pointer, stack pointer and instruction pointer. These are three 16-bit register. Base pointer, it is used to store the offset address. Stack pointer, it is used to store the top of the stack. Stack is nothing but the some portion of, to access the data very quickly, some portion we are using in the memory, that portion is known as the stack. The top of the stack address is stored in stack pointer. Next, IP, instruction pointer. This is the most important, instruction pointer. Always we are storing instruction pointer. It is a 16-bit register. From where we are, the address of the next instruction to be executed stored in the instruction pointer. In instruction pointer, what we are storing? Address of the next instruction to be executed. Suppose we are writing the programming sequential lines. Suppose whatever the instruction we are executing, that address is stored in the instruction pointer. Okay. Address of the next instruction to be executed. Currently, I am executing this instruction. The next address is stored in the instruction pointer. By default, microprocessor moved into the instruction pointer. It verifies the address, it moved that location, execute that instruction. Okay. Address of the next instruction to be executed stored in the instruction pointer. Next, index registers. Two index registers: source index and destination index. Generally, these registers are used in string operation to move the string from left to right and right to left. In that case, we are using these two registers, source index and destination index. This is about the register organization of the 8086. Okay. Coming to the architecture part. Okay. If you observe the architecture, it is divided into two blocks. One is BIU and second one is the execution unit. First, functionalities of BIU. What are the basic functionalities of the BIU? If you observe the BIU, it is connected to the memory or interface. For external world, the BIU only connected to the external world. Okay? If you observe, it consists of the segment register, it consists of the summer, it consists of the instruction. Okay? Here, what we are doing, first, here in bus interfacing unit, calculate the 20-bit physical address. 20-bit physical. What is this 20-bit physical address? Okay. If you see, what is the address bus width of the 8086? Sorry, 20-bit. Address bus width is 20-bit. So it consists of the 20-bit address. What is the register capacity in 8086? Register capacity in only 16-bit. Okay. Is it possible to store the 20-bit address in 16-bit register? Is it possible to store 20-bit address in 16-bit register, it is not possible. So we are calculating the 20-bit physical address. How we are calculating the 20-bit physical address? That is calculated by this block. This is nothing but the summer. How we are calculating the 20-bit physical address? 20-bit physical address calculated by using one formula: 10H into base address plus offset address. Base address plus offset address. Base address is nothing but the segment address. Offset address is nothing but the displacement. By using two 16-bit values, we are calculating the 20-bit physical address. That 20-bit physical address is calculated by using summer. Okay. To calculate the 20-bit physical address, which registers we require? Base address is always stored in the segment register. Okay. So segment registers are connected to the summer. Okay. Next one is the instruction pointer. Okay. In instruction pointer, what we are storing? From where we are fetching the next instruction. Okay. Address of the next instruction to be executed stored in the IP. So it calculates the 20-bit physical address. Okay. It verifies the IP. It goes to the memory location, fetch that instruction and stores in this. It fetches the instruction and stores that instruction in instruction queue. Stores that instruction in instruction queue. Okay. This instruction queue, how many instructions we are storing? It first fetch the instruction, store it. Next it fetch the instruction, next. It stores 16 instructions. Okay. Instruction queue consists of the, it stores the 16 instructions. Okay. Coming to this instruction queue is in the format of the FIFO. FIFO means first in, first out format. Instruction queue format is first in, first out. Okay. This instruction queue, we are using the concept that is nothing but the pipeline. Okay. In the 8086, we are using only two-stage pipelining. Which two-stage is nothing but the fetch and execute. Okay. What is the use of the pipeline? Suppose simple example. How we are executing the program? First it fetches the instruction. Okay, instruction fetches. First it fetches the instruction. Okay. It fetches that instruction and send it to the decode that instruction and send to the ALU. ALU execute that instruction. Okay. Next it is going to fetch the second instruction. Okay. If you do it like this, the execution time will be increases. By using the pipelining process, execution of the current instruction and fetching of the next instruction is doing simultaneously. Okay. Executing of the current instruction and fetching of the next instruction we are doing simultaneously. That is known as the pipeline. Okay. Here, I am here executing the first instruction, fetching the next instruction. But if you see the queue, first it fetch the instruction one. Okay. When instruction one is going for the execution, it fetches the instruction second and it keep it in instruction. Okay. Simultaneously, how many operations we are performing? Here we are executing the first instruction, we are fetching the second instruction. So by using this pipelining concept, we can increase the processor speed. We execute very quickly. Okay. Pipelining is nothing but the executing of the current instruction and fetching of this next instruction is simultaneously is known as a pipeline. That pipelining concept is we are using in instruction queue. Okay. If you observe the what is the functionalities of the BAU, it fetches the instruction from the memory by seeing the instruction pointer. It is used to calculate the 20-bit physical address by using the summer. Okay. We are using in BAU another functionality is it prefetches the instruction and stored in instruction queue. Okay. This instruction queue consists of the 6 instruction. This instruction is in the form of the FIFO. First in, first out format. Okay. In instruction queue, which concept we are using? We are using the pipelining concept. Pipelining is nothing but the executing of the current instruction and fetching of the next instruction simultaneously is known as the pipelining concept. Okay. Our which stage pipeline we are using in 8086? It's two stages. What are those stages? Fetch, execute. Simple. By using this diagram, you can understand very easily. Two-stage pipeline, I am explaining here. Okay. Here, during first class cycle, class second one, class second two I am taking. Suppose instruction one, okay, instruction one. During first class cycle I am using addition instruction in fetch is okay. Fetch, execute. Okay. During the instruction one, right? You don't know your instruction. During the first clock cycle, instruction 1 is fetched. During second clock cycle, instruction 1 we are executing the instruction 1, we are fetching the second instruction. Okay. During the first clock cycle, only instruction 1 is fetched. During second clock cycle, we are executing the instruction 1, we are fetching the instruction 2. Like this, okay? Simultaneously, we are performing two operations. Okay, this is about the basic functionalities of the bus interfacing unit. These are the functionalities of the bus interfacing unit. Coming to the execution unit. Okay, coming to the execution unit. The basic functionalities of the execution unit is whatever the instruction fetched and that instruction is stored in instruction. When you know, we are fetching the instruction and we are storing that instruction in instruction. The execution unit. What is that? It reads the instruction from the instruction queue and execute that instruction. Control system decode that instruction and decode that instruction and send to the ALU for the execution purpose. ALU, it perform the arithmetic and logical operations. Okay. To execute that instruction, where we are storing the operands, generally the data is stored in the these registers. AX, BX, CX, DX, base pointer. Okay. Source index, destination index and stop pointer. Okay. While execute the instruction, it use the data from these registers and execute that instruction and store the result in the accumulator. It is going to update the flags. It is going to update the flags. Okay. Coming to the functionalities of the execution unit. Okay. The functionalities of the execution unit. Functionalities of the execution unit. Okay. The functionalities of the execution unit. Okay. The functionalities of the execution unit is whatever the instruction we are stored in the instruction queue, that is decoded by the control system, that is sent to the ALU. The ALU reads the data from the general purpose register, execute that instruction and store the result in the accumulator, and it is going to update the flags. Okay. In next video, I am going to explain about the flag format and what is the flag register content. Thank you. It performs arithmetic and logical operations and it stores the result in accumulator and it is going to update the flags. Okay. Another important register in 8086 is flag register. Okay. Flag is nothing but the after performing the arithmetic and logical operation, the status of the result, whatever the result we are getting, the status of the result is given by this flag register. What is the status? Suppose performing arithmetic and logical operation, maybe it is negative number. In that case, we are generating any extra carry. Okay, what is the parity of that result? Okay, is there any overflow? The status is given by this flag register. Okay, the flag register is, it is a 16-bit register. It gives the status of the result. Okay, this is about the architecture of the 8086. Okay, thank you.